هذه الحلقة برعاية خدمات التدريب المقدمة من المدربة ومقيم الجودة المعتمد سارة العلي. من خلال برنامج مهارات القهوة يمكنكم الحصول على شهادة معتمدة من جمعية القهوة المختصة العالمية في عدة دورات، منها مهارات البارستا، مهارات تحضير القهوة اليدوية أو المقطرة، ومهارات العلوم الحسية. لمزيد من المعلومات يمكنكم الاطلاع على التفاصيل في أسفل الحلقة.
Welcome to the Daily Coffee Pro by Map It Forward and Map It Forward Middle East. This is the Swapcast. This is episode 2 of our 5-part series with myself and the host of our Middle East podcast, Sara Alali. Welcome back, Sara.
Hello.
So in this episode, we're talking about the difference between having a pop-up cafe versus having a grown-up full brick-and-mortar cafe, which is what you did. And you did that in a very challenging time. You transitioned from your pop-up to the stationary, beautiful cafe in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, called That. What's the difference between, in your experiences, what's the difference between having a pop-up and having the brick and mortar?
Oh, big difference. Yeah. So the pop-up is a pop-up, and I might start with telling you what is the what are the similarities.
Okay.
So at that time, it was challenging times. Why? Because as I told you before, that at that time, like, I couldn't own my cafe or work in my cafe, so. In that period of time, I found a solution for that, and I overcome the obstacles by having a pop-up where I can go in small buildings or large buildings and be there for the cafe and serve customers and work as a barista and manage the business. In this, like, the stationary location and the cafe, it's also challenging times because we have, it's like post, or let's say after the pandemic and all the economic changes in the world, and also with the increased taxes. So it's both challenging, and yani alhamdulillah, I tried as much as possible to find solutions. What is the difference from... regarding the weight on my heart. Oh. The pop-up was easier to manage, and it's more, let's say, less responsibility. Mm-hmm. And in this new stationary cafe, it's a huge responsibility. Because the pop-up, you can just, you know, close the cafe and put the pop-up aside. It's just a thing of 1, 2, 3 days, or even 1 month or 2 months. Mm. But the cafe, you have a contract with the for rent. You're obliged to pay it, whether you are running the business or not. So in the pop-up, you have more flexibility with this. You don't have the money. You just close and keep it on the side. Or... like, we had a lot of support in that we were offering this service for free, so we didn't have to pay rent.
Right.
We are offering the service, people are buying, but we're not paying rent. So without the rent, I can tell you, it's very, like, more
it's relieving. One of the heaviest burdens on a business, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the heaviest parts, because... as I said, it's like one of the expenses that you cannot get rid of. So it's there. It's a fixed expense that you're going to have to pay it, whether you run the business, whether you're selling, not selling, you're having profit or not. Yeah. The other thing, it's also about money. And like the team, I would hire people that I need for the specific event, and I will pay them by daily fees. But in the cafe, you need to have employees, and you need to have a team, established team. You need to train them. You need to have established team. And because you can't just have people that are there for one day or one week or one month or on a monthly basis, like just, you know, short-term contracts, because you need people to run the business. And also the salaries are heavy. It's not something easy to pay.
I want to say something on the salaries there, if that's okay. There's something, folks, that's very unique about Saudi Arabia when it comes to salaries. This is something that I think people will find fascinating. In Australia, America, the United Kingdom, Canada, etc., etc., baristas are paid as hourly workers. And mm-hmm. they're not permanent employees. They don't get a salary. And so this makes, while they're still expensive, if somebody's not working out for you, because they're a casual employee, they can be gone. Whereas everyone that works in a cafe in Saudi Arabia is a permanent employee that gets a monthly salary. And
yeah,
far
but
more.
At the same time, it's like, it's a challenge as well. Like if you don't have, if they're casual employees, so they can just leave you anytime.
Totally.
So
totally.
It's different. Here we have a contract. So yep. We have to find an exit strategy, you know, see things how they work for us both. But we yeah. have to play it right.
Right.
Yeah.
But it just puts it's a heavier burden for cafe owners in Saudi, right? Yeah. If on this side, if we want to get rid of somebody because they're not doing the right thing, we can get rid of them. But similarly, like you said, they can leave. Whereas for you, this is a whole process.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Mm. Also, during the time when I opened the pop-up, we didn't have to pay any taxes.
Sales
now
tax,
it's 15.
Nothing.
Yeah, now it's 15%. So I went from zero taxes to 15%. Way different. And still people are expecting the same prices. That's the thing. Like people are expecting the same prices back in 2016 and now in we're almost 2023.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and like in the pop-up, I didn't have the taxes, I didn't have the rent, I didn't have to pay permanent employees, and now I have to pay rent, and I have to pay employees, and I have to pay other charges, and then the tax, and also...
And inflation?
This inflation, and then I have to pay, keep the prices as is. So... as it was before. So yeah, this is a big challenge. Also in the pop-up, we had like the flexibility to move around, to change, like we would have the, I built it in a way that you can do it as a U-shape, L-shape, straight line, and you have a full cafe. Everything is there. Everything you need is there. You just need the walls. And you can move it. And it's really nice.
It's
because when, yeah. And it's very flexible and it's very practical because anywhere I go, I just do the shape that suits the customers and mm-hmm. the building. Now, no, it's fixed. Like we had some like limitations in the building, of course, mm-hmm. like the shape and like it's a square. It's more like a rectangle than a square. Mm-hmm. So you have to go with the shape and where the water source is coming. You have to build the bar depending on where you have the water supply, where you have the electricity, and all of this. We didn't experience in the pop-up. Also, like I would buy only what I need for an event. Now I have to have a stock, mm-hmm. an inventory, and you do the stock taking, and it has to be more consistent, and it has to be, you have to be more persistent. It's not like in a pop-up. In a pop-up, you just like pop up. Get the stuff that you need. Okay, let's get some paper cups from here. We just have a stamp on it with that logo, and or we get stickers, and it's just white plain white cups with our sticker. So it's much cheaper and you just get what you need. Now I need to have enough because you never know. Like one day you will have more customers and you need to have the supply. And it's not easy to print cups just in 1 week. So you need to have a stock. Yeah. Plus, like, you have to be more consistent in the menu. Like in the pop-up, we would change the menu every time, depending on where we are, on the what the customer needs from us, if it's, you know, winter, if it's summer. So there's that joy. Maybe this is the joy that in the flexibility that I had. But here, no, it's more consistent and fixed. And you have to go by the rules, the standards, and you have more limitations.
Yeah, wow. I mean, so many people say, I've got a pop-up. It's doing really, really well. I'm just going to go and open a brick-and-mortar place, a permanent cafe. That's just going to make everything easier.
Yeah.
Did it make everything easier?
No.
It's also two different businesses, right?
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It's not just scaling up or no, it's two different businesses. And also, as we are discussing, it's the pandemic. Like, I don't know, maybe before the pandemic, it will be the same business. I don't think so. So, and also, like, I had the flexibility as Sara, like, during the pop-up, if I don't have an event, I'm not working, I can go and learn about coffee. I can travel. I can take courses. I can give courses. Now it's like, even I have the license to train people, I can't, like, I don't have the time to go and do training sessions like before. So this extra revenue, I don't have that luxury, you know, anymore.
Right.
So in the pop-up, like, the revenue is not high and it's decent, but I still have other sources of revenue.
Income.
In the cafe, or income. In the cafe now, it's different. Like, I have to be there. I can't have this luxury of time going, traveling more or learning about coffee or training sessions. So, yeah, this is like what I'm experiencing now.
It sounds like the difference between being an auntie and being a mother.
Yeah, exactly. This is what it is. Yeah. And also between having just, you know, I don't know if it's a proper
terminology,
example, but it's you know, like in a pop-up, you don't have this what I want to say, like, you don't have partners, you don't have it's
more freedom.
It's more freedom. Now, no, I have partners and you have to manage the expectations of the partners, of the team, of you as well, like what expectations you set for yourself, of the customers. Like, also manage also the communication between all of these different players. I didn't have that in the beginning, like as a pop-up. So even the team, I still have part, like some of the people who used to work with me now, they're in that, in the actual place. And it's different. It's different even for them.
Wow.
Like, even you can tell that the joy that they used to experience in the pop-up, it's much different. There's something about the pop-up that was very, it was light, like on the heart.
Yep.
Yeah.
It sounds like you went from this really joyous experience where everything was new and then everything got super serious. And it was like, I was there with you the whole time.
I got the word that I'm looking for, is it's the risk.
Ah, okay.
Okay. So here in the pop-up, there are no risks. Like, what is the worst case scenario? I'll just close the pop-up.
Right.
صح? But in the actual location here, with all this, you know, you have the commitments and the responsibilities. You can't just say, "I'm gonna shut off everything. Yalla, we're leaving." Yeah,
yeah.
So it's too risky.
And folks, like, just a heads up: this is not your standard kind of pop up. Like, this pop up is super beautiful. I hope people start building pop-ups like your pop-up was. You can't even using the term coffee cart to explain this pop-up is not even close to what it is. It's gorgeous, but it came with a sense of freedom. It came with a sense of flexibility. It came with a sense of lightheartedness and exploration into different customer bases and all this kind of stuff.
And peace of mind.
Don't you miss peace of mind, Sara?
Yeah, I do.
Again, difference from being an auntie and a mother.
Yeah. Plus, right. It's like it's something that you cannot reverse anymore. No. When you're a mother, you're just a mother. خلاص. You can't reverse it.
So that is like the perfect segue into our next conversation. We're going to have a conversation about how has owning a business changed you? So
let's do it.
Next episode, folks. Peace of and peanut butter. Have an amazing rest of your day.
أعزائي شكراً لمتابعتكم وحسن استماعكم. إن شاء الله تكونوا استفدتوا واستمتعتوا بحلقتنا، ونتمنى أنكم تكونوا جزء من مجتمع مابت فورورد. إذا حابين تنضموا لنا ادعمونا على صفحتنا في منصة باتريون patreon.com/mapitforward.